I coming to you live from the UTPA Fieldhouse in the three-time All-American City of Edinburgh. This is Bronx Basketball. Tonight, the UTPA women's basketball team returns home for the first time since November 21st, the span of five games and nearly a calendar month, as they host the University of Texas at Arlington Mavericks. Well, the Bronx went 3-2 on their road trip, and usually you'll take that, a winning record on a long road trip. Won their first three, wins over Norfolk State, Northern Iowa, and Houston Baptist. Stumbled at Texas A&M Corpus Christi, and then got beat by TCU on Sunday. Well, now the Bronx come home for one before hitting the road again for three more. In that game against TCU, Bronx actually had more offensive rebounds than a bigger team, scored more second-chance points, fell 73-47. Brittany Bush continues to roll along, recorded her third double-double with 13 points, 10 boards, and 2 steals. Seventh time she's led the Bronx in rebounding this season. Well, Kaylin Boyd led the Bronx in scoring for the fourth time this season with 14 points, 4 boards, and 2 steals. Well, at 5-4, the Bronx are off to their best start since 2008-09, when they're also 5-4. The Bronx also had 5-4 starts 3 other times. The only better starts in program history were in 07-08 and 91-92, when the Bronx were 6-3. Now, if the Bronx win tonight, they'll tie for the best start in program history, and if they win the next two games, they'll have the record all to themselves. Now, that's pretty good. Bronx is 16th in the NCAA in turnover margin, 18th in three-point field goal percentage defense, 20th in field goal percentage defense, 32nd in scoring defense, 46th in three-pointers per game, 80th in steals per game. I want you to keep in mind that's out of about 350 teams. Brittany Bush, 42nd in the NCAA in blocks, 167th in rebounds, and when you're that high up, it also means you're going to be ranked somewhere among the WAC leaders. The Bronx lead the WAC in 6 different categories. They're 2nd in a few, 3rd in a few as well. A lot of it comes to defense, though, and there are a lot of stats about how good the Bronx defense has been. I think the best one I can tell you is simple. They're allowing just 57.6 points per game, the 2nd lowest mark in program history. The record is 57 points, set in 04-05 when the Bronx were 42nd in the NCAA in scoring defense. So, Bronx certainly have defensive ability, and they hope tonight to show off some shooting ability as they take on the UT Arlington Mavericks. We'll take a timeout coming up on Bronx pregame. It's the Coach's Corner. I sit down with Bronx head coach Larry Tidwell. This is Bronx Basketball.
Here, we understand how a team is the result of being part of something larger than yourself. Creating a better outcome and a better tomorrow. Doctors Hospital at Renaissance is proud to support the University of Texas Pan American Bronx.
Dr. Pena, does LASIK surgery work?
LASIK surgery is America's most frequently performed elective procedure. In fact, I've helped thousands of patients see better.
Dr. Pena.
Call me Raulito.
Thousands and thousands. Raulito, are you sure?
Is that thing on?
Yes.
Follow me. I had to put him somewhere. It's a big project.
That's a lot of successful operations. Call Dr. Raulito Pena at 661-UC.
The phone keeps ringing. Gotta make room.
It's the Red Tack Sales event at South Texas Buick GMC. Come in today and claim your Red Tack cash on just about all of our Buick and GMC inventory. It's the Red Tack Sales event at South Texas Buick GMC. Not the biggest, just the best.
Larry. Welcome back to Bronx Pregames, Coach's Corner. Jonah Goldberg with Bronx head coach Larry Tidwell. And Coach, first time home in almost a calendar month. Is it weird being in the field house before a game?
Well, I tell you, it's always good to be back home. And we've been on a five-game road swing, and we went 3-2. You know, I felt like we should have won another one of those games, but right now we're on pace to have that winning season that we want, and we just got to keep our heads above water, and we got to play really good tonight against a tough UTA team. You know, their record doesn't indicate how good of a team they have, but they have good inside play and they got excellent guards.
Last time out at TCU, you know, it was a game that TCU is TCU, and they won by a few. So when you look at that game, what are you looking for from your team when you try to evaluate that game?
Well, I look at every possession. I want to see how our kids react to pressure, how they reacted to a long 2-3 zone, you know, the coverage that they had. And I'm looking to see if they're trying to improve, to see if we can penetrate gaps. I'm looking at defensive transition. I'm looking at how we're playing ball screens. We're trying to learn on every possession. And if I get effort, then I'm okay with it. But if we don't get the effort and get the play that is smart play, then I'm not very happy.
Do you think that when you play a team like that, you can that the players can actually learn a lot to help them improve as you head towards the WAC?
Well, I tell you, we will improve from this. There's no question, because they are an excellent team. But again, I got UTA tonight. I've got looming in the horizon. I've got Nebraska Omaha, who has a good team. I've got Wichita State in the top 50 in the country. Then I got Oklahoma State, who is either 10th or 11th in the country at 8-9-0. So we have our hands full, and we got to improve each and every day. You know, it's the WAC is typically a one-team league. You know, you got to win your tournament to get to the NCAA tournament, but we're just going to continue to fight and see if we can get better every day.
One player who played really well at TCU, Brittany Bush, came up with a double-double.
That's her third of the year, and when she goes, we usually play pretty good. We got behind early because we simply couldn't hit any shots, and we had open looks. I go back and I look at my offense, I'm saying, what am I doing? You know, but I just watched it again tonight before tip-off, of trying to pick up on things I can do better as a coach, and we just got to put some shots in the basket, and if we do that, we'll be pretty good.
Bush leads the WAC in blocks per game. She's among the tops in rebounding. She's also nationally ranked 42nd in blocks, 167th in rebounds, which is out of thousands of players. Those are some pretty good numbers.
Yeah, she's putting up good numbers, and I expect her to put up even better numbers. She's a tremendous athlete, and when she relaxes and when she thinks through it, reverse pivot, I mean, she got a beautiful shot. When she does all those things, she's going to be a really dominant player, I think, and she'll only continue to get better. You know, we work at it very hard. Coach Ishii has the post players, and he does a good job with her, and then I take her on the side, too, and we just got to get her better at the free throw line, and we got to get her better on making a little bit better decisions when she has the ball.
What can you tell us about UT Arlington?
UT Arlington, I just like their guards. I like their post players. Both post players are averaging like double doubles. I mean, the number 21, number 44. You know, the number 21's a kid I knew from Fort Worth, from Modi White High School. I've known her since she was a seventh grader. And Brianna Walker's her name, and she is a great kid. And I just hope tonight she doesn't have one of those double doubles. But they're going to press us. They're going to run a zone on us, and we got to execute, and we got to hit some shots.
And finally, talk a little about the kind of emotion that's going to be in this game, honoring our late team photographer, Dutch Calgill.
You know, we're going to play hard each and every game, but this is a special game to honor Dutch. Dutch was a great friend. You know, we lost him last week, and I'm glad that UTPA stepped up and is doing something to honor him. And Jonah, I appreciate what you're doing in this situation, because I know putting a video together about Dutch and everything is really first class, and that is very much appreciated by not only women's basketball, but our entire athletic department.
Coach, well, thanks a lot and good luck.
We're going to play hard, and all I can tell you is we're going to fight him until hell freezes over, and then we're going to fight him on the ice.
That was Bronx head coach Larry Tidwell. That'll do it for the Coach's Corner. We'll take a timeout. When we come back, we'll have your starting lineups and opening tip. This is Bronx Basketball.
This commercial brought to you by Lax Furniture, an official sponsor of the University of Texas Pan American Intercollegiate Athletics.
Madness is calling. The 2014 WAC Men's and Women's Basketball Tournament. March 12th through the 15th at Orleans Arena in Las Vegas. 16 teams battle through the brackets on their way to the big dance. Be there to see who will go home the big winner.
Ticket packages on sale now at utpabronx.com.
Brave and bold, silver and gold.
We're on a mission. Aggie up.
Bronx country just got a whole lot bigger.
Mighty Wolverines of UVU.
Join the herd. Lopes up.
Bold moves, big season, grew up.
We are the new gold standard.
We will be champions.
We are the Western Athletic Conference.
Welcome back out to the UTPA Fieldhouse. Jonah Goldberg riding with you courtside as we count down to the start of tonight's game between the UTPA Bronx and the UT Arlington Mavericks. Running through the starting lineup, so we will do the same, and we are going to start with the visiting Mavericks. Starting at the point guard position, 5'3 senior out of Yukon, Oklahoma, number 22, Layla Suleiman. At the shooting guard position, 5'8 junior out of Lufkin, number 12, Chantandra Williams. At small forward, 5'11 junior out of Wichita, Kansas, number 11, Talia Pope. At power forward, a 6'1 senior out of Fort Worth, number 21, Brianna Walker. And at center, a 6'3 senior out of Katy, number 44, Deshara Wanguma. The head coach of the Mavericks in her first season is Krista Gerlich. She's assisted by Kristen Cole, Ashley Crawford, and Talby Justice. The Mavericks enter this game with a record of 0-9. That includes an 0-5 road record. As for those host UTPA Bronx, you can line up a little bit of a different lineup. A new point guard for the first time this season. A 5'7 junior out of Wichita, Kansas, number 14, Tondria Nolan. At shooting guard, a 5'6 junior out of Gardner, Kansas, number 3, Tonisha Walker. A small forward, a 5'8 freshman out of Copperas Cove, number 11, Shante Goff. At power forward, a 5'8 junior out of Chicago, Illinois, number 1, Jasmine Thompson. And at center, a 6'1 junior out of Moline, Illinois, number 21, Brittany Bush. The head coach of the Bronx in his first season is Mr. Larry Tidwell. The associate head coach is John Ishii, and the assistant coaches are Anthony Anderson and Hannah Burleson. The Bronx entered this game with a record of 5-4. They've lost their last two times out. On the road, or at home this season, I should say, the Bronx are 2-1. The officials for, well, let's not worry about that. The Bronx are in their home white tops and bottoms with the bright lime green shoes and orange and white socks. Green numbers on the front and on the back in orange trim with the lettering spelling out Bronx across the front. Same combination, a WAC logo in the upper left-hand corner, Bucking Bronx on the back above the number. I'll be moving right to left. The Mavericks in their road blue tops and bottoms with the orange and white stripes down the sides. White numbers on the front and on the back in orange trim. The white letters UTA across the front above the number in orange trim. The head of the horse on the back above the number. They'll be moving left to right. Mwanguma wins the tip. Now we're underway, moving from right to left across your radio dial with the Mavericks in blue. First shot bounces in, and the Mavericks out to a quick 2-0 lead. A little bit of full court pressure, Bronx trying to break through. Nolan running the offense. Pass to the right, over to Walker. Dumps it off to Thompson, right corner, misses on the jumper. Rebound Mavericks, here we go the other way. Pretty good crowd out here at the field house. A lot of middle school and high school youth teams, both basketball and dance teams, and cheer teams, a couple of which are going to be performing at halftime today. Most of the crowd, as they're wont to do, is sitting right behind me, which means they're underneath the camera, which is why you don't see them. But hopefully you can hear them through our crowd mic. Certainly a few hundred here already. Turnover for the Bronx, forced by the Mavericks. Walker, jumper, 4-0 Mavericks. Nolan brings the ball down the court, and pass gets deflected out of bounds. It remains Bronx ball with 23 on the shot clock, 18:44 game clock, and it's already 4-0 Mavericks. Bush in the right corner. Passes it out to the right wing, Nolan. Game that's sure to be fraught with emotion for the Bronx. Shot is blocked. Walker saves it along the baseline. Passes over to Thompson. Fires it up at the buzzer. Misses the rim. Shot clock violation. It is Mavericks ball. Just a couple of minutes before game time. Dana Cowgill, the wife of our late team photographer, Dutch Cowgill, entered to a chorus of hugs from anyone who could get to her. She is the cheer coordinator of a cheer team at Donna, a middle school in Donna. And a three-pointer good for Suleiman. 7-0 Mavericks. And Dana's team will be performing at halftime in honor of Dutch, and we're going to show you that performance at halftime. Also at halftime will be a special video tribute to Dutch, which we will show you as well. Emotional moment of silence before the national anthem. There is a wreath set up in the right corner near the Bronx bench, and that's where you could find Dutch a lot during games. It's a good angle for him to shoot from. And it's also by the table where he sat down if he needed a break or left his bags. Bush misses but gets fouled, so Brittany Bush heads to the line. Bronx trying to get their first points, 2:09 in, down 7-0. Bush is 24 for 40 from the line this season, that is 60%. First free throw goes in. Second shot off the back iron. Here come the Mavericks. Ball down low, that's Walker. And it's 9-1, Mavericks. Brianna Walker with four. There's a three ball on the way from Goff, no good, an offensive board. Nolan finds Walker right wing. Walker steps in, tries to pass it underneath. That's stolen by the Mavs. Here comes UTA, and pass ends up going into the stands where hits off of Jim Board, one of the top basketball players in Bronx men's basketball history, was on the 63 championship team. Key contributor to the Bronx Athletic Fund as well. Always sits courtside, both men's and women's games. Goff takes a seat. Terrell Price is in. Travel, Bronx ball. 3 minutes gone by. The Bronx are down 9-1. Nolan. That's left wing Thompson. Thompson throws it up, misses, and it goes out. It's Arlington ball. Basketball. 16:45 to play in the first. Bronx down 8. There's a steal by Thompson. Here come the Bronx. 1-on-3 to the basket. Thompson draws the foul in the act of shooting. Well, that's probably about as well as you could hope for that one to go. I mean, 1-on-3. Thompson will have a chance to score some points. Thompson is 9-for-15 from the line this season. That is 60%. And the first one goes in.
Substitution for the Mavericks, number 3, Malaika Green, replaces number 12, Sean Tundra Williams.
Malaika Green replaces Sean Tundra Williams for UTA. One more free throw coming up for Thompson. Good. 9-3. Bronx going full court pressure. Green, basketball left wing. Top to Suleiman. Walker, backs it in, pass it out. Ball gets dumped down low, Teo. Now to the left wing, Green. Jumper, doesn't fall. Offensive board, her shot deflected by Bush. Out of bounds, and remain Mavericks ball. 16 minutes even on the clock, Bronx down 9-3. Bounce comes to the corner to Green. Walks to the left. Shot is knocked away by Bush. It goes out of bounds. And the Bronx ball when we return. 15:51 to play in the opening half. The Bronx are down 9-3. You're watching Bronx basketball.
Here. We understand how a team is the result of being part of something larger than yourself. Creating a better outcome and a better tomorrow. Doctors Hospital Renaissance is proud to support the University of Texas Pan American Bronx.
Dr. Pena, does LASIK surgery work?
LASIK surgery is America's most frequently performed elective procedure. In fact, I've helped thousands of patients see better.
Dr. Pena.
Call me Raulito.
Thousands and thousands. Raulito, are you sure?
Is that thing on?
Yes.
Follow me. I had to put him somewhere. It's a big project.
That's a lot of successful operations. Call Dr. Rolito Pena at 661-UC.
The phone keeps ringing. Gotta make room.
It's the Red Tax Sales event at South Texas Buick GMC. Come in today and claim your Red Tax cash on just about all of our Buick and GMC inventory. It's the Red Tax Sales event at South Texas Buick GMC.
Not the biggest, just the best.
Welcome back out to the UTPA Fieldhouse. Jenna Goldberg riding with you. 15-51 to play in the opening half. Bronx down 9-3, still looking for their first field goal. All 3 points on free throws. UT Arlington going 2-3 zone. Coach Tidwell talked about this a little bit on this week's edition of Bronx Country, which aired not that long ago on Time Warner Cable Sports Channel and is now available online at our website, utpabronx.com. And talked about it a little bit on the coach's show this week that went up last night on 956sports.com. And he basically said that teams are going to zone the Bronx until their shots start to fall. Bronx shooting 33% from the field this year. They're holding opponents to 34. Coach Tidwell even said in jest, all right, opposing teams, now you know what to do. But Tanisha Walker showing she can shoot a little bit. Bronx within 9-6. A bank shot by Green. Mavericks lead is 5. And the Bronx turn it up, or well, get thrown out of bounds, but tipped on the way out, so. It remains Bronx ball, 27 on the shot clock. Thompson. Top to Walker. Walker, pass underneath, picked off. Here come the Mavs. Suleiman, pass, knocked away, but goes out of bounds. Remain Mavericks ball. Ball to the corner. Thompson for 3. In and out. Rebound Mavs. Green. That's 13-6. Nolan. Feeds Thompson right corner. Bush coming in, throws it up, misses. Rebound Walker. Quickly ahead to Pope. Mavericks don't wait. They run the tempo up. There's a foul and free throws coming up.
Personal foul is on number 21, Brittany Blake. Her first, team's first.
Bush gets called for her first foul. As Walker's first shot does not fall. Walker, 67% free throw shooter. Mavs of its team at 70%. Thompson out, Goff back in for UTPA. Second shot is good. It's 14-6 Mavs. Walker takes a seat, Tonisha Walker, and Alexandria Hill is in. And Brianna Walker takes a seat as well for the Mavs. As Shatundra Williams comes back in for UTA. Another special visitor to today's game, and I must mention, Dolia Gonzalez, the mother of Edinburgh legend Freddie Gonzalez. Oh, very decorated war hero, Shante Goff. Nails the three. Bronx within 14-9. Team 16 to play in the first. Dolly Gonzalez, effectively the adopted grandmother of the team, is what the Bronx call her at today's game. She's sitting right behind the bench, right behind Coach Ish. Bronx playing aggressive defense, almost were able to force a turnover. Now the three, right wing at the buzzer. And Malika Green with 7 points now. It's 17-9 Mavs, and it seems every time the Bronx get a basket, UTA has an answer. They are holding the Bronx at arm's length. Goff tries to respond, and she does! 17-12! 12.5 minutes to play in the first. To the corner, comes to the right wing. Suleiman nails the three. It's just become a back and forth long range shooting contest. Bronx down 8 again. See if the Bronx go back to Goff. They do. She's open again. And she nails it again. Shante Goff left wide open for three straight possessions. She nails them all. The Bronx within 5. It's 20-15. 11:45 to play in the first. Ball comes to the right wing. There's another three from Suleiman, and I don't believe it. Another three-pointer. And what, have we seen, what, 6 straight three-pointers from these two teams? Hill's going to try a three off the back iron. Rebound Mavericks. Boy, if that had gone in, I tell you. Williams, left wing, there's another three coming, and it's good. Jim and knee. Suleiman with back-to-back threes, and it's 26-15 Mavericks. The Bronx have hit 3 of their last 4 shots. They've all been from behind the arc, and yet somehow the Mavericks have increased their lead. You know why? Because they're, what, are they 4 for their last 4 now? All from behind the arc? Bush misses a layup inside, trying something a little different from what we've seen the last few minutes. Mavericks get the board. Suleiman, right wing Green. She hit one of the recent threes for the Mavericks. They'll go inside too, and the bank is open for Williams. And it's 28-15. Pass by Bush, knocked away, stolen by the Mavs, under 10 minutes to play in the first. Here comes UT Arlington. Green, matched up with Goff. Green, moving to her right. Goff sticks with her. Ball comes out to the top. Nolan overcommits. Pass down low. Hits our camera. Luckily, we had the up cam and not the floor cam on. Otherwise, it would have come right into your living room. And we're up against a media timeout. 9:39 to play in the first. Bronx down 28-15. You're watching Bronx Basketball.
This commercial brought to you by Lax Furniture, an official sponsor of the University of Texas Pan American Intercollegiate Athletics.
Madness is calling. The 2014 WAC Men's and Women's Basketball Tournament. March 12th through the 15th at Orleans Arena in Las Vegas. 16 teams battle through the brackets on their way to the Big Dance. Be there to see who will go home the big winner.
Ticket packages on sale now at utpabronx.com.
Welcome back out to the UTPA Fieldhouse. Jonah Goldberg riding with you. 9.5 minutes to play. Bronx down 28-15. Bronx 4-7 from behind the arc. UTA 5-6. And most of that came in the last 2 minutes. It was just three counter three. It's been something to see. Hill for three. Got it! We're 10 minutes into this game, and both teams have five threes. You keep up that pace. Traveling, Bronx ball. Goff is 3 for 4. Hill, 1 of 2. Walker, 1 for 1 for the Bronx. How about Suleiman? She's 4 for 4 for UT Arlington. Green, 1 for 1. Well, he'll try another three. That one didn't fall. Goes out. Remains Bronx ball. So another chance to maybe throw up another three. Well, now Chazé right, left wing. Takes a step in, feeds Goff. She's open again, and she nails it again! Chazé Goff is 4 for 5 from behind the arc. Only played 11 and a half minutes. Bronx within 7. Well, on a night like this where every three-pointer is falling, I don't care how much either team goes up by. No lead is safe. Hill, layup, no good. But a foul, so she'll head to the line, try and convert a couple of free throws.
Personal foul is on number 21, Brianna Walker. Her first team 7. At the line for the Bronx, number 2, Alexandria Hill, shooting 2.
Hill's first free throw, nothing but net.
Substitution for the Mavericks, number 25.
Hill from the line this season. Actually, this is her first free throws of the season. Huh. Let's see how she did last year. Hits them both. It's a 5-point game. Hill was 5 of 8 from the line last year. Well, the Bronx were down 13 just 2 minutes ago, but on an 8-0 run. And with that turnover, the Bronx have a chance to make this a one-possession game for the first time since it was 9-6. Seven straight baskets were three-pointers from the 13-27 mark to the 10-59 mark. Four of them for UTA, 3 for the Bronx. Hill thought about it. Thompson's gonna do it. And she hits it! That's ridiculous! And amazingly awesome all at once. And Alexandria Hill gets whistled for a foul. Right around the inbounds. Well, Bronx going full court pressure. It's a 2-point game. The Bronx are on an 11-0 run over the last 2.5 minutes. Jordan Hollab with the ball. A layup? That's not a three-pointer. 30-26 Mavericks. Let's see what we get on the other side. Right. She's outside the arc. Bronx are 7 of 11. From, make it 8 of 12. The Bronx are 8 for 12 from behind the arc today. And how about Alexandria Hill picking up the offensive foul? It's Bronx ball when we return. 7-1 to play, and it is an old-fashioned shootout. Bronx down one. Now this is Bronx basketball.
Here, we understand how a team is the result of being part of something larger than yourself. Creating a better outcome and a better tomorrow. Doctors Hospital Renaissance is proud to support the University of Texas Pan American Bronx.
Dr. Pena, does LASIK surgery work?
LASIK surgery is America's most frequently performed elective procedure. In fact, I've helped thousands of patients see better.
Dr. Pena.
Call me Raulito.
Thousands and thousands. Raulito, are you sure?
Is that thing on?
Yes.
Follow me. I had to put him somewhere. It's a big project.
That's a lot of successful operations. Call Dr. Raulito Pena at 661-UC.
The phone keeps ringing. Gotta make room.
It's the Red Tax Sales Event at South Texas Buick GMC. Come in today and claim your Red Tax cash on just about all of our Buick and GMC inventory. It's the Red Tax Sales Event at South Texas Buick GMC.
Not the biggest, just the best.
Welcome back to the UTPA Fieldhouse. Jonah Goldberg riding with you. Bronx are 8 of 12 from behind the arc. They're within 30-29. They had been down 13 just a couple of minutes ago. The way this is going, if this keeps up, this could be one of the all-time great performances in Bronx history. The Bronx have only reached double figures and three-pointers in a game 8 times. Ever.
Substitution for the Mavericks, number 12, Chantondre Williams, replaces number 4, Jordan Holland.
Last season, the Bronx high in three-pointers made was 12 against Chicago State, third most in program history. That was a February game. She's gonna do it. Oh. But almost an offensive board, a foul. Well, Bronx 8 of 13 now. This is a lot of three-pointers going up. And this is already the most three-pointers the Bronx have made in a... game this season, besting the 7 they made in their 25-point comeback at Houston Baptist on December 3rd. Allison Teo picks up her second foul. That's already 9 on UT Arlington. Wow. Shante Goff to the line. First one doesn't go, so she'll not get a second. Rebound Mavericks. 6:13 to go, and a wild and crazy first. Brianna Walker. It's it up, or well, gets knocked away out of bounds. Remain Mavericks ball. That's an offensive foul. Bronx ball.
Foul is on number 21, Brianna Walker. Her second, team's 10.
Good in the foul.
Count the basket. Personal foul is on number 11, Shantae Goff. Correction, foul is on number 1, Jasmine Thompson, her first team's pick. At the line for the Mavericks is number 11,
35-29. Bronx have gone as close as 1. They've been down as many as 13. Thompson puts it up, banks it in.
Jasmine Thompson.
35-31, Bronx within 4.
Go defense! Go defense!
Chantondra Williams lays it up, no good. Rebound, Bronx can make it a one possession game with a basket here. Nolan, along the baseline, gets fouled.
Personal foul is on number 11, Talia Hope. Her first.
Go, Bronx!
The Mavericks are over the limit. At the line for the Bronx, number 14, Teandria Nolan, shooting 2.
First free throw off the front iron for Nolan.
Substitution for the Mavericks, number 10, Brianni Bruce, replaces number 11, Talia Pope.
Still Mavs ball.
Go defense!
Green. Williams. Top to Green.
Go defense!
On the right wing, Walker. Walker. Offensive foul. Bronx ball. And if the Bronx can hit one of their threes here, they could tie the game for the first time. Bronx 8 of 13 from behind the arc. Shantae Goff leading the way. She's 4 for 5. Thompson along the baseline. Kicks it out right for the tie. Doesn't fall. Bush the board. Bucket wouldn't go in, but she got fouled. Chance to get the Bronx within 1 if she hits them both. Talia Pope, getting ready to check in for UTA. No good on the first. Bush now 1 of 3 from the line. Wright takes a seat for UTPA. That's Thompson, Nolan, Bush, Price, and Walker for the Bronx now. Brianna Walker took a seat for UTA. Williams brings the ball up the court. Williams along the right wing. Top to Green. Left wing, Bruce. Bruce passes it out to the right wing, Williams for three. Doesn't fall. Rebound, Bronx. The Bronx can tie it or take the lead. And that chance will still exist when we return. 3:47 to play in the first. The Bronx down 35-33. Now you're watching Bronx basketball.
This commercial brought to you by Lax Furniture, an official sponsor of the University of Texas Pan American Intercollegiate Athletics.
Madness is calling. The 2014 WAC Men's and Women's Basketball Tournament. March 12th through the 15th at Orleans Arena in Las Vegas. 16 teams battle through the brackets on their way to the Big Dance. Be there to see who will go home the big winner.
Ticket packages on sale now at utpabronx.com.
Back we are at the UTPA Fieldhouse. John Goldberg riding with you. First half, 3:47 to play in the Bronx, down 35-33. Been down by as many as 13, a pull to as close as one. And a quick whistle.
Personal foul is on number 10, Brianni Bruce, her first. Mavericks are over the limit.
So Teandre Nolan hits the line. A chance to tie the game for the first time today. It's the first. Nolan now 2 of 3 from the line today. Bronx have been one. Second shot rims out, rebound Mavs. So the Bronx within one again. This is as close as they've been throughout the game. Good full court pressure by the Bronx. UTA's got 2 seconds to get it up the court. One, zero, that's a violation! Great defense by UTPA to force the 10-second violation. And now with 3:33 to go in the first, make a wish because the Bronx with the basket can take their first lead of the game. Nolan, left wing Thompson. Thompson spins, feeds Price. So top to Thompson. Cycles right, 12 on the shot clock, 11, 10. Top to Nolan with 9, 8. Right wing Thompson for the lead, in and out. Rebound Mavs, that's Teo. Goes up to Green. Green along the right wing directs traffic. Bruce with 6. There's the 3 for Green. It's good.
3 points for Green.
Here come the Bronx. Nolan. Walker in the right corner with 2.5 minutes to play in the first. Nolan trying to move bodies. Left wing Thompson. Right wing Walker for 3. Short. Bounds, it's Mavericks ball. Make sure you stay tuned at the half. We'll have the Dutch Cowgirl presentation in its entirety. Both the tribute video and the performance by his wife's cheerleading team. We'll also have your first half stats. Foul. Williams will head to the line. Williams going to line for the first time today. This is on the first. She's now 2 for 3 this season. Second shot is good. It's a 5-point game. 2 minutes left in the half. Hill along the right wing, up top to Nolan. Left wing Thompson. Thompson, baseline, jumper, no good, but a foul. Thompson 2 for 2 from the line today. The Bronx are 8 of 13 from the line. First shot good by Thompson. Bronx within 4. Second shot is good. Bronx within a possession. It's 39-36. Green along the right wing. Top to Williams. Jumper left elbow doesn't go. The rebound is swatted. Still Mavericks ball, 29 on the shot clock. Minute 20 game clock. Bronx within 3. Need to stop. There's a jumper by Teo, doesn't go. Rebound Bronx. And the Bronx hit another 3. They can tie it here. 8 of 16 from behind the arc is UTPA. All 8 came in the first 11 minutes of the game as Preston's hook doesn't fall. Minutes ago in the first, it's Mavs ball. And the Mavs decide to use their use it or lose it timeout. A 30-second timeout. They're now announcing Dolia Gonzalez in attendance. Mother of decorated war hero, Freddie Gonzalez. Here in Edinburgh, we've got a street named after Freddie Gonzalez, a middle school as well. Great to see Dolia in attendance. A nice round of applause. Williams out near center court. Call a foul on Nolan. Her first, that's 7 on the Bronx. And that means it's 1-1 for Allison Teo. Did a nice job of drawing that call. Teo 11 of 20 from the line this season, that's 55%. Making her first trip today. 48.5 ticks of the clock left in the first. A miss. And now it's Coach Tidwell's turn to use a 30-second timeout. 44.7 seconds left and 27 on the shot clock. This is Tidwell's opportunity to draw up a play to try and tie the game if he so chooses going into the half. I think you do. You know, I'm all for there's still another 20 minutes after this 44.7 seconds, so you don't need to get it all here. And I agree with that. But I think from a mental standpoint, if you can go into the locker room tied after trailing the entire half, that's a big boost for UTPA, and that would really be a morale herder for UTA. So I think you draw up a play for a three. Rocks are 8 of 16. It's interesting, though, that Shantae Goff has not re-entered the game. She's 4 of 5 today. Only has one foul. Nobody has more than one for the Bronx. Wow, I'm looking at the other side. Brianna Walker has 4 for UT Arlington. Suleiman has 3. Ooh, Coach Tidwell uses up another timeout. The first one was the use it or lose it. You don't carry all of your timeouts over, but he stamps his foot to the ground as he called this timeout. I guess the play wasn't unfolding as he drew it up. So he has a talk with his team. 31.1 left. 13 on the shot clock. Remember, stay tuned at the half. We will have your first half stats as well as full coverage of the tribute to Dutch County. Thompson with the ball at the top. 9 on the shot clock, 8. 7 to Hill. Top to Price for the tie. Off the back iron, rebound Mavericks, and now they can hold out. That's exactly what Coach Gerlich tells them to do for the last shot. They want to ensure they go into the locker room leading this game. Williams misses. 3 seconds left. Price to Nolan, who slips, lets off the half court heave. That's going to miss wide right. When we go into the half, the Bronx trail 39-36. Considering the lead the Mavericks had early, if I'm UTPA, I take that in a heartbeat. Because UTA, they got to run away with this game. Now the Bronx have kept it close, and we go into the half of the game. 39-36, Mavs. We're going to take a timeout coming up on Bronx at the half. We'll have the first half stats and full coverage of the Dutch Cowgirl ceremony. This is Bronx Basketball.
Here, we understand how a team is the result of being part of something larger than yourself. Creating a better outcome and a better tomorrow. Doctors Hospital Renaissance is proud to support the University of Texas Pan-American Bronx.
Dr. Pena, does LASIK surgery work?
LASIK surgery is America's most frequently performed elective procedure. In fact, I've helped thousands of patients see better.
Dr. Pena.
Call me Raulito.
Thousands and thousands. Raulito, are you sure?
Is that thing on?
Yes.
Follow me. I had to put him somewhere. It's a big project.
That's a lot of successful operations. Call Dr. Raulito Pena at 661-UC.
The phone keeps ringing. Gotta make room.
It's the Red Tax Sales Event at South Texas Buick GMC. Come in today and claim your Red Tag cash on just about all of our Buick and GMC inventory. It's the Red Tag sales event at South Texas Buick GMC.
Not the biggest, just the best.
Welcome back out to the UTPA Fieldhouse. Jonah Goldberg riding with you. Score of the half is 39-36 UT Arlington. Quick look at the first half stats. Layla Suleiman leads the Mavs with 12 points, 4-4 shooting all from behind the arc, 3 assists, 2 steals. 10 points, Malika Green, 4-5 shooting, 2-for-2 from behind the arc, 2 assists. 9 points for Thalia Pope, 3 boards, 2 steals. 5 points, 4 boards, Brianna Walker, and 3 points for Santandra Williams. The Mavs, 14 of 25 from the field, 56%. 6 of 9 from behind the arc, 5 of 8 from the line. 17 boards, 4 offensive compared to 14 and 6 by the Bronx. Shante Goff leads the Bronx in scoring with 12 points, 4 of 5 shooting all from behind the arc. After that, 9 points for Jasmine Thompson. It's 5 points for Alexandria Hill with 4 assists. 3 points for Tanisha Walker, 3 for Shazay Wright, and 2 for Brittany Bush and Tandra Nolan. The Bronx are 9 of 25 from the field, 36%, supplemented by 8 of 18 from behind the arc. So only one shot has gone in from inside the arc for UTPA. 10 of 15 from the line. Points in the paint, 10 to 2 UTA off of turnovers, 17-12 Bronx. Second chance, 4 to nothing Bronx. There hasn't been a lead change. There has not been a tie. We give you all these numbers. But the only ones that matter, 39-36, UT Arlington leads UTPA at the half. Quick look at how the men are doing. Men are at SMU. They have 11 minutes and 12 seconds left in the first half, and the game is tied at 13 apiece. Well, that's a look at your first half stats. We're going to turn it over to the video tribute. I'll be honoring the life of Dutch Cowgill right now, and then we'll come back for the performance by Dana Cowgill's cheerleaders from Donna Middle School. Bronx down 39-36 at the half. You're watching Bronx Basketball.
No one person brought more joy to our student athletes during home events than Dutch Cowgill. His title had been team photographer since November of 2010, but in reality, he had been the memory maker for the UTPA student athletes. On December 10th at 5:35 p.m., Dutch passed away. He was 59. He is survived by his wife, Dana, who resides in Edinburgh. The special thing about Dutch is that he never took photos for the money or the marketing aspects. He took the photos so the student athletes would have memories that they could cherish for years to come. He cared so much about our student athletes, and all he ever wanted was a thank you. He was a good photographer and an even better person. I'm proud to have been able to call him my friend. Now, we would like to give our coaches and staff an opportunity to remember Dutch while showing you some of his best work.
On behalf of the Department of Collegiate Athletics, we send our deep sympathy to the Cowgill family and his wife, Dana. Dutch was an integral part of the UTP Athletics and believed in our mission and vision of student-athlete success. He was at every event. Even knee surgery couldn't keep him away from the baseball games last spring. On a personal note, he was always very supportive towards me behind the scenes. He never doubted the changes and the growth and always lent a supportive word. In our quest for promoting Bronx athletics, Dutch was at the forefront of making our initiatives come to life. We will miss his commitment, his support, and his positive demeanor. After every home event over the last 2 years, I had the opportunity to say thank you. I just want to take this opportunity to say thank you one last time.
Dutch Cowgill has been a very hard day for me because you described Dutch first class and genuine. He will be missed by UTPA Bronx Athletics. He was a great person.
He was a nice man. You can tell that he really enjoyed what he did. And I think the reason why he enjoyed it so much was because he knew the pleasure and the thrill that he was giving each and every one of our athletes. After he took those pictures and he gave the pictures, or we would give the pictures to our athletes, the joy and the thrill of watching themselves, in particular senior day. He would take the pictures that we would put on the frames with the jersey for our seniors. And I think Dutch was the type of individual that could see and feel the joy that he was bringing to each and every one of our athletes. So we're really going to miss Dutch. He was one of a kind, nice man with very positive and very endearing personality, and we're really going to miss him.
He will be sorely missed. Caught us all off guard. Was a great guy. He's been doing our headshots and taking pictures of our team the entire time I've been here. So, again, it's a great loss for the Bronx and the department as a whole, and our best to his family.
Dutch was a great guy. We loved having him at all of our home events. All the girls really enjoyed seeing him around. He felt like he was a part of our team when he was out there, just because we had seen him so often. He had gotten so comfortable with everyone, and I loved having conversation with him, small talk. Sometimes he relaxed me during our matches when I got a little bit too stressed out about the little things. So it was always nice to see him. Even at some of the other programs' games, having a chance to talk to him was always really pleasant.
Still, deeply shocked and saddened by the news of Dutch's passing. I don't know that it'll truly fully hit until we don't see him on the sidelines at basketball games and baseball games, and then really the full effect for us in our program next fall when he's not there. But we lost a great man, a great person, and someone who was a huge asset to our program. But that's the least of things there. He was just such a great person that he always wished you the best, wanted the best, just had a moment to just chat briefly. He was great with my family, and that's something that really hit home over the last 24 hours is through him and his eyes and his camera, I was able over the last 2.5 years to see my children growing up, because every time we walked in an arena, whether it was volleyball, baseball, basketball, it didn't matter. That camera popped out and he was shooting pictures of my wife and my kids. And so we kind of went back last night a little bit and went through some of the pictures and saw their progression through, like I said, through his eyes, through the lens of the camera that he always had with him. And that's going to be missed, obviously. But like I said, he was just a top-notch person and someone that this program and this university and this world can't replace.
Student athletes took to Twitter after learning the news. Women's tennis player Regan Greenwood tweets that she was in shock and that Dutch will be greatly missed by everyone. Women's basketball player Kaylin Boyd tweets, "Rest in peace, Mr. Dutch. Amazing guy. It was great always being able to talk to you. You believed in us when we didn't believe in ourselves. You will be missed. Just won't be the same without your face behind that camera. Just can't believe this." Track and field's Rebecca Rodriguez tweets, "Too many times am I reminded how life is way too short. You never know when you will talk to someone for the last time. Always be kind. Rest in peace, Mr. Dutch. Your kind heart will be missed." Track and field's DeAndre Barroso tweets, "Rest in peace to one of the kindest men I had the privilege of meeting. Who knew Friday would be the last time we would see him taking pictures of us?" Former baseball player Guadalupe Barrera tweets, "May you rest in peace, Dutch. God bless you and your family. Thank you for being such a great photographer, but most importantly, a great friend. God bless." That tweet retweeted by current baseball player Matt Daniels. Volleyball player Macy Singleton tweets, "So sad, brought me to tears. Such a kind and caring man, and he will definitely be missed." Volleyball player Corinne Acuff tweets, "Rest in peace, Dutch Cowgill. I will never forget the encouraging compliments you give me after the games for having such high spirits." And local TV sports reporter Joe Bowling took to Twitter as well, saying Dutch Cowgill was always the first one to walk over and say hi when covering the Vipers and the Bronx. Dutch Cowgill, UTPA Athletics team photographer, friend to many, husband to one, gone at 59.
Madness is...
give it up one more time for the Todd Middle School cheerleaders under the direction of Dan Calgo. Fans, at this time, the UTPA Spirit team, composed of our cheerleaders, Blazers dance team, and Bucky, are presenting.
Well, we hope you enjoyed that tribute.
The poster has a collage
to Dutch Calgill
that Dutch took of the Spirit program over the past 2 years.
Right now on your screen, you're seeing Dana Calgill. She's being walked out to center court with the cheer and dance program. This a surprise even to me, as they have created a collage of some of the photos that Dutch took of them over the years. And they are presenting it to Dana right now at midcourt. What a gesture.
One more big round of applause for Jeff Calgill and his wife Dana for all of the hard work and what they've done for UTPA Athletics. Thank you very much. Fans, Massage Envy, Office Furniture USA, Pena Eye Institute, Renaissance Casa de Palmas, Rio Bank, Rudy's Barbecue, and South Texas Buick GMC are all official sponsors of the University of Texas Pan American.
We have to take a timeout. Bronx down. 3 at the half. We'll be right back.
Here, we understand how a team is the result of being part of something larger than yourself. Creating a better outcome and a better tomorrow. Doctors Hospital Renaissance is proud to support the University of Texas Pan American Bronx.
Dr. Pena, does LASIK surgery work?
LASIK surgery is America's most frequently performed elective procedure. In fact, I've helped thousands of patients see better.
Dr. Pena.
Call me Raulito.
Thousands and thousands. Raulito, are you sure?
Is that thing on?
Yes.
Follow me. I had to put him somewhere. It's a big project.
That's a lot of successful operations. Call Dr. Raulito Pena at 661-UC.
The phone keeps ringing. Gotta make room.
It's the Red Tack Sales event at South Texas Buick GMC. Come in today and claim your Red Tack cash on just about all of our Buick and GMC inventory. It's the Red Tack Sales event at South Texas Buick GMC.
Not the biggest, just the best.
This commercial brought to you by Lax Furniture, an official sponsor of the University of Texas Pan American Intercollegiate Athletics.
Madness is calling. The 2014 WAC Men's and Women's Basketball Tournament. March 12th through the 15th at Orleans Arena in Las Vegas. 16 teams battle through the brackets on their way to the big dance. Be there to see who will go home the big winner.
Ticket packages on sale now at utpabronx.com.
Brave and bold, silver and gold.
We are on a mission.
Aggie up.
Bronc country just got a whole lot bigger.
Mighty Wolverines of UVU.
Join the herd. Lopes up.
Bold moves, big season, grew up.
We are the new gold standard.
We will be champions.
We are the Western Athletic Conference.
Back out to the UTPA Fieldhouse. Jonah Goldberg riding with you. The score as we start up the second half is 39-36 in favor of UT Arlington. Bronx is down by as many as 13. They've gone as close as one. They have not led. It has not been tied. But they start the second half with the basketball. So all it takes is a three. I make it sound so simple. But the Bronx have hit eight of them today. There's one coming from Goff. No good. Goff now 4 of 6 from behind the arc today. And the Bronx will be able to tie it, but first now they'll need a stop and then a three to try and tie it. But UTA starts off the second half with a basket, and it's 41-36. UTA with the basketball. 5-point Mavericks advantage. Minute gone by in the second. Green matched up with Goff. Top of the key, Suleiman. Down low, layup missed. Rebound, traveling, and it's Bronx ball. Goff with the basketball on the left wing. Pass it to Bush. Bush, fade away. No good, rebound, her shot is blocked, a foul. And Brittany Bush heads to the line for a couple of free throws.
Bush from the line today is 2 for 4. Bronx are 10 of 15. She hits them both. She can make it a one-possession game. That's 3 fouls now on Wanguma. Number of Mavericks in foul trouble. First free throw good. Wanguma has 3. Suleiman has 3. Brianna Walker has 4. That's probably why the Mavs didn't go with their starting 5 to start the second half. I mean, Walker still on the bench. It's a one possession game. It's 41-38. Offensive board for UTA. Nolan, left wing Goff. Thompson puts it up, bounces around, just won't fall. The biggest hurdle the Bronx have been trying to leap throughout this game has been when it's a one possession game, traveling Bronx ball. Bronx been able to get it within a possession several times, but it seems as if every time it relatively quickly becomes a two possession game or more by UTA. Nolan. The ball straight away. This is the left wing Thompson. Puts up the 3. No good. Rebound Pope. Williams. Left wing Suleiman. Comes to Wanguma. In the right corner, there's a 3 on the way for Williams. Doesn't fall. Rebound Nolan. Nolan racing down the court. Gets it over to Walker. Comes in. Left wing Thompson to her left to Goff for a 3. Ties the game! 41 all! After the first time tonight, the score is the same on both sides of the ledger. Green, top to Pope. In and out, rebound, and a putback attempt to foul. Bush picks up her second foul. She's the first Bronx to reach 2 fouls today, which is always a good sign. Wanguma. It's the first, and the Mavs have their lead back. Second shot is good. ...43-41 Mavericks. Goff comes inside, dumps it for Bush, lays it in! 43-all. Nearly thrown away by UT Arlington. Bronx in a full court press. Suleiman breaks through. Suleiman into the lane, throws up the floater, doesn't fall. An offensive board and a bucket for Wanguma. 45-43 Mavs. Thompson. Goff. Banks it in. Tied at 45. Bronx knock it out. Second comes off the clock. Mavericks ball when we return. 15-18 to play. Game tied at 45. This is Bronx basketball.
Here, we understand how a team is the result of being part of something larger than yourself. Creating a better outcome and a better tomorrow. Doctors Hospital Renaissance is proud to support the University of Texas Pan American Bronx.
Dr. Pena, does LASIK surgery work?
LASIK surgery is America's most frequently performed elective procedure. In fact, I've helped thousands of patients see better.
Dr. Pena.
Call me Raulito.
Thousands and thousands. Raulito, are you sure?
Is that thing on?
Yes.
Follow me. I had to put him somewhere. It's a big project.
That's a lot of successful operations. Call Dr. Raulito Pena at 661-UC.
The phone keeps ringing. Gotta make room.
It's the Red Tack Sales Event at South Texas Buick GMC. Come in today and claim your Red Tack cash on just about all of our Buick and GMC inventory. It's the Red Tack Sales Event at South Texas Buick GMC.
Not the biggest, just the best.
Well, the Bronx knew one for seven from the inside the arc wasn't going to cut it. So here in the second half, already two for six to go with one for three from behind the arc. While scoring, UTA 9-6 to tie the game at 45. There have been three ties in the last few minutes after none in the first half. Bronx still looking for their first lead, but they're going to get that here. They're going to need to stop at a basket. Minutes to go. A little floater from Williams doesn't go, and a foul. Well, they're at halftime now at SMU. UTPA men's basketball is within five. It's 40-35. Now, Coach Hipscher talks about it a little in this week's edition of Bronx Country. He says that, you know, SMU is a better team than TCU. And look at the Bronx. Miss on the other end, a rebound, Mavericks. 21, 20, just get across. Bronx coaching staff wanted to travel there. Oh, there's the travel. You get it now, you get it later, it comes. It's Bronx ball, 14-10 to play with the game tied at 45. Preston, Goff, Walker, Nolan, Thompson. Fights her way in, no good. Rebound, Wanguma. Game still tied at 45, a little bit of a scoring drop for these two teams. Bronx have gotten a few stops, but haven't been able to hit the basket to give themselves their first lead. Another miss by UTA, but an offensive board. Green was wide open. Whistle, but no immediate call. She might have slid her feet. Did Green while trying to fake out her opponent. Let's see. What are they calling? Two of the officials discuss it without actually making a motion, and now the third official asks what's going on, and now they're heading to the table. Sherelle Price gets ready to check in for the Bronx. Replacements Jasmine Thompson, and I have no idea why they blew a whistle. allowed the Bronx to make a substitution. Williams misses. Here come the Bronx, trying to take their first lead of the game. Price spins around and gets fouled. Free throws coming up. Price's first shot is good. The Bronx have their first lead of the game. It's 46-45 with 13:16 to play. Second shot good. 47-45. Walker takes a seat. Allie Hill back in for the Bronx. Played well today. 4 assists, 5 points. Suleiman with the basketball on the right wing. One of 3 Mavericks with 3 fouls on the court right now. Ball down low, is knocked away by Goff and out of bounds. Remains Mavericks ball, but just 8 on the shot clock. Steal. Nolan, straight to the hoop, lays it in. And an offensive foul on UT Arlington. It's Bronx ball. Bronx have scored the last 6 points. Nolan. Price for 3. No good. Goff gets the board. Dumps it out to Hill on the right wing. Up top to Nolan. She'll start up a new play. Nolan has the open seam. Kind of got off balance a little. She tried to make the turn towards the basket, couldn't. And on the other side, the Mavs draw a foul. Hill picks up her second. Second on the Bronx. Bronx lead is 4. Suleiman goes to the line for the first time today. First shot goes in. Suleiman, 21 for 22 from the line this season. That's pretty good. It's a one possession game. Second shot is good. It's a 2-point game. Looks like Thompson is going to run the offense right now. Nolan takes a seat. Thompson, ball poked away, gets it back with 12, 11, 10, 9, 8, down low to Price with 5, throws it up, good enough, offensive foul. And Coach Tidwell disagrees, and he lets the official know as much as he waves his hand at him. 11:38 to play, 49-47 Bronx, this is Bronx basketball.
This commercial brought to you by Lax Furniture, an official sponsor of the University of Texas Pan-American Intercollegiate Athletics.
Madness is calling. The 2014 WAC Men's and Women's Basketball Tournament. March 12th through the 15th at Orleans Arena in Las Vegas. 16 teams battle through the brackets on their way to the big dance. Be there to see who will go home the big winner.
Ticket packages on sale now at utpabronx.com.
Welcome back out to the UTPA Fieldhouse. Jonah Goldberg riding with you. 11:37 to play. Bronx up 49-47. Mavericks ball. They can tie it with a basket here. No shot. Away from the ball. I saw a green fall to the floor. And Cheryl Price gets called for a foul. It's her third. First Bronx with three. That's four on the Bronx. Bronx trying to preserve their lead. They need a stop to do so. Green with the ball out at center court. Top of the Bronx leg. 20 on the shot clock. Ball down low underneath. Stepping out of bounds is Pope, and it's Bronx basketball. Go Bronx. 11 minutes to go. Bronx by two. Price. Hill. Goff. Thompson. Let's it fly. Goes in. Jasmine Thompson. 51-47. Bronx 4-point lead ties for their largest of the game. There's the layup, doesn't go. A rebound, a whistle, and a foul. And a technical. I think I know who is on, but let's just be sure. Officials talk it over, and yep, technical on Teo.
Personal foul on number 25, Allison Teo, and a technical foul on number 25, Allison Teo.
So she gets the personal and the technical.
At the line, number 11, Shante Goff.
So Goff heads to the line. The first one rims out. Well, the second one is good, so the Bronx lead is five. That's their largest of the game.
Go Bronx! Go Bronx! Go Bronx!
Thompson lays it in! 54-47, it's a 7-point lead. The Bronx have turned around 20 points. They had been down 13, they now lead 7, and the Mavericks call for timeout. 10:09 to play, Bronx by 7. This is Bronx basketball. Mavericks.
Here, we understand how a team is the result of being part of something larger than yourself. Creating a better outcome and a better tomorrow. Doctors Hospital Renaissance is proud to support the University of Texas Pan-American Bronx.
Dr. Pena, does LASIK surgery work?
LASIK surgery is America's most frequently performed elective procedure. In fact, I've helped thousands of patients see better.
Dr. Pena.
Call me Raulito.
Thousands and thousands. Raulito, are you sure?
Is that thing on?
Yes.
Follow me. I had to put them somewhere. It's a big project.
That's a lot of successful operations. Call Dr. Raulito Pena at 661-UC.
The phone keeps ringing. Gotta make room.
It's the Red Tack Sales Event at South Texas Buick GMC. Come in today and claim your Red Tack cash on just about all of our Buick and GMC inventory. It's the Red Tack Sales Event at South Texas Buick GMC.
Not the biggest, just the best.
Back out to the UTPA Fieldhouse. Jonah Goldberg riding with you. At the half, it's 54-47.
Go defense! Let's go defense!
Or halfway through the half, I should say. 10 minutes to go. Bronx have trailed by as many as 13. They now lead by 7. They've turned around 20 points. Two on the shot clock. One. Shot clock violation. Hill put her hand straight up to block it. And it's Bronx ball. Bronx on a 9-2 run over the last five and a half minutes. Hill for three. No good. Rebound, a foul.
Personal foul is on number 20, Sherelle Price. Her fourth, team's fifth. Out of bounds. It remains Hamlet's basketball.
I'll have to try that inbounds again. Meantime, Tanisha Walker replaces Alexandria Hill. Shazay Wright in, Sherelle Price out. So it's Thompson, Walker, Goff, Wright, and Bush for the Bronx right now. Mavericks with Green, Pope, Suleiman, Teo, and Harris. The hoop is Pope. She gets fouled. Two free throws coming up for Pope. I was correcting myself. The Bronx had been on an 11-2 run over a 5.5 minute span. Mavs trying to end that right there. Chantandra Williams in. Malika Green out. Second shot is good. 54-49. Goff. Launches a deep two, misses wide left. Rebound Mavs. Williams, right wing. That's Harris for three, air ball, rebound. Pope, no good, but on the third try, the Mavs get a basket, and don't look now, it's a one possession game. 54-51, the Bronx need a basket. Thompson gets it in.
Justin Thompson.
56-51. Bronx back up by two possessions. 8 minutes to go. Shuttle pass down low. Layup doesn't fall for Williams. A rebound, Thompson. Here come the Bronx. And Thompson dribbles it off of the foot of Teo, and it goes out of bounds. Bronx ball when we return. 7:47 to play. Bronx lead 56-51. This is Bronx basketball.
This commercial brought to you by Lax Furniture, an official sponsor of the University of Texas Pan American Intercollegiate Athletics.
Madness is calling. The 2014 WAC Men's and Women's Basketball Tournament. March 12th through the 15th at Orleans Arena in Las Vegas. 16 teams battle through the brackets on their way to the Big Dance. Be there to see who will go home the big winner.
Ticket packages on sale now at utpabronx.com.
Welcome back out to the UTPA Fieldhouse. Jonah Goldberg riding with you. 7:44 to go, and it's 56-51 Bronx. Goff on the right wing. Palms it, UTA ball, 7:27 to go. Pope comes out to the right wing, that's Suleiman, nails another three, that's her fifth. And it's a two-point game. It's 56-54.
Go Brooks! Go Brooks! Go Brooks!
Thompson. Bob for Bush. Bush walks underneath. Having trouble holding on to the ball. Wasn't able to get it down onto the ground for a dribble. So suddenly, in a one-possession game, it's Mavericks' ball, and they can tie the game with a basket here. Ball gets loose, but picked up by Suleiman. Suleiman's 5 for 5 from behind the arc today. I wonder if he'll try and find her for the lead. Instead, they go inside. Layup doesn't go for Pope. A rebound, Bronx. Bush cleaning up the trash underneath. That's our fifth. Goff responds. 4-3. Bronx lead by 5. Williams. So left wing, Harris. 14 on the shot clock. 6 minutes even left in the game. Harris coming around. Can't find her way in. Pass out to Suleiman with 5, 4, 3, 2, one. Suleiman forces it up wide right. Shot clock violation. It is Bronx basketball. 5:44 to play. And now the Bronx call for a 30-second timeout. Updating you on how the men's basketball team is doing. There's 17 and a half minutes left up at SMU. And the Bronx within 43-38, so it's still a five-point game. In that game, Javon Farrell leads the Bronx with 13 points and 7 rebounds. Shaq Boga, 12 points, 3 assists. Here, the Bronx are led by Shante Goff. She's got a career-high 21 points. She's 6 of 9 from behind the arc. That's pretty good. Jasmine Thompson with 15 points to her own. 5 boards, 2 assists, 2 steals. Thompson along the sideline, dribbling it out with 13, 12, 11, 10, 9, 8, 7, 6, lets it fly, and hits it! The Bronx have their 7-point lead back at 61-54. Thompson's got 17. Thompson isn't far off her career high. She has now a season high in scoring. Thompson's career high, 21 points last December against Texas Southern. This becomes a 5-point game again. Thompson doing a good job controlling the basketball today. Bush knocks down her opponent, gets called for the offensive foul. Bush has 3, and it's Mavericks ball with 4:39 to play. Teo. Coming the other way.
Offensive foul. Foul is on number 11, Talia Pope. Her fourth, team 7.
Pope's got 4 fouls now. That's 2 Mavs with 4 fouls. And they're both in the game, and Walker and Pope. Suleiman and Teo each have 3. They're in the game as well. Williams, the fifth one, she's got 2. A lot of fouls for UT Arlington today. Bronx has done a little bit of a better job, although more foul, this many fouls in this half as in the second, or as in the first, I should say. Offensive board, a fresh possession for UTPA. Thompson. Nine, eight, seven, six. Walker, good on the foul! Donatia Walker. Oh. Well, everybody in the gym thought it was a defensive foul except for the official closest to it, and he's is the only opinion that matters. Offensive foul called, and it's Mavericks ball when we return. 3:36 to play, 61-56 Bronx. You're watching Bronx basketball.
Here, we understand how a team is the result of being part of something larger than yourself. Creating a better outcome and a better tomorrow. Doctors Hospital Renaissance is proud to support the University of Texas Pan-American Bronx.
Dr. Pena, does LASIK surgery work?
LASIK surgery is America's most frequently performed elective procedure. In fact, I've helped thousands of patients see better.
Dr. Pena.
Call me Raulito.
Thousands and thousands. Raulito, are you sure?
Is that thing on?
Yes.
Follow me. I had to put him somewhere.
It's the Red Tack Sales event at South Texas Buick GMC. Come in today and claim your Red Tack cash on just about all of our Buick and GMC inventory. It's the Red Tack Sales event at South Texas Buick GMC.
Not the biggest, just the best.
Dr. Pena, does LASIK surgery work?
LASIK surgery is America's most frequently performed elective procedure. In fact, I've helped thousands of patients see better.
Dr. Pena.
Call me Raulito.
Thousands and thousands. Raulito, are you sure?
Is that thing on?
Yes.
Follow me. I had to put him somewhere. It's a big project.
That's a lot of successful operations. Call Dr. Raulito Pena at 661-UC.
The phone keeps ringing. Gotta make room.
Immediately off the inbounds, the jump ball. Possession arrow favors the Mavericks. A nice job by the Bronx guarding the inbounds. His next possession arrow is theirs. The Mavericks get it in. They lose it. Thompson's got it. Lays it in. Oh, what a game for Jasmine Thompson. 19 points for the junior. And another steal for UTPA. And that's three steals now for Thompson. She's doing everything today, huh? That's a career-high tying three steals for Thompson, I should say. Attempted a career-high 15 shots. She's made seven of them. 4-4 from the line. Ties her career-high in free throw makes. Teandria Nolan hits the first. Green in, Williams out for UT Arlington. Second shot off the back guy, and a rebound for the Mavericks. All down low, that's an uncontested layup for Brianna Walker. Bronx lead is cut to 64-58. 3 minutes to go. Nolan finds Goff, left wing, wide open again, and she nails it again! Shante Goff is 7-for-10 from behind the arc! And the scary part is, she's got a pitched battle with Jasmine Thompson for player of the game honors. It's 7-for-10, and the amazing part is, she keeps getting left wide open. Thompson trying to grab the steal. Ball gets loose on the floor. Jump ball situation. Possession arrow favors the Bronx.
Jump ball. Possession arrow to the Bronx.
.223 to go. Full court pressure by the Mavs. Goff over to Nolan with 20. There's Walker for three off the back iron. Rebound picked up by the Mavs. They're coming in 3-on-2. Green waited too long. We're 5-on-5 now. There's the three. Suleiman with a rare miss. And a rebound for the Bronx. Minute 36 to play. Bronx by 9. Nolan, it off to Thompson. Thompson coming in, throws it up. No good, but a foul. Thompson heads the line for two free throws as she hits them both. She only has to hit one to have a new career high in free throws made. She hits them both, she'll have tied her career high in scoring. And Talia Pope just fouled out for the Mavericks. Finishes the game with 11 points, 7 rebounds, 2 steals. 3 of 9 shooting, 5 of 5 from the line. Jean-Tendre Williams back in for the Mavericks. The Mavericks are going to call for time out. Minute 19 to play. Bronx up 9. Here in the second half, the Bronx outscoring the Mavericks 31-19. And currently, the Bronx on 11-4 run over the last 4.5 minutes. Actually, it's longer than that. Nobody has scored in the last minute and a half. Through the last 6 minutes, the Mavs have been held to a pair of Breanna Walker layups. That's it. While Shante Goff nailed a pair of threes, Jasmine Thompson has hit a pair of two-pointers, and DeAndre Nolan's hit a free throw. Thompson at the line for two. First shot is good. 20 points, Jasmine Thompson.
Way to go, Jasmine.
The Bronx have a 10-point lead for the first time today. Make it 11. Thompson ties her career high with 21 points. And the Bronx lead is 69-58. Bronx applying defensive pressure. A minute 10 to go. Layup, no good. Rebound, put back, doesn't fall. This rebound grabbed by Nolan. Nolan getting chased around in the backcourt. Fires it up in transition. Bush underneath. Looked like there might have been some contact as the ball gets knocked out of bounds. The Bronx will retain. 22 on the shot clock, 57.1 game clock. Already up 11. Thompson for a long two. No good. Rebound out to Walker. And the Mavericks have to foul. Walker at the line. That's the first. The Bronx are at 70. Make it 71. 49 seconds left. 15-4 run for UTPA. And this is coming the other way. 9.7 differential between shot clock and game clock. 39.7 seconds left, so the Bronx will take one more shot. Full court pressure for UT Arlington. Goff, it's trapped and fouled with 35.5 seconds left. Goff will head back to the line.
Personal foul is on number 21, Breanna Walker, for fifth. She has fouled out.
And Breanna Walker just fouled out for UT Arlington. Well, the Bronx today, 11 of 29 from behind the arc. 11 three-pointers is the fourth most by the Bronx in any game in program history.
In for Breanna Walker is number 25, Allison Teo.
Teo in for Walker. Goff hits the first. What's Shante Goff? 25 points. Not bad for the freshman. Not bad at all. That one goes in, 72-60. And a technical foul assessed to UT Arlington. Presumably on the coach.
Technical foul on
Mavericks head coach, Mr. Gerlich. Yep, it's on Coach Gerlich. Got that technical right after calling a 30-second timeout with 26.6 seconds left. And the Bronx up by 12. Jasmine Thompson misses on the first technical free throw. If she can hit this second one, though, she'll have a new career high in scoring. She got it. 73-62, Jasmine Thompson, new career high, 22 points. Or 73-60, I should say. Bronx by 13 with 26.6 seconds left. It's their ball, so unless UTA is going to foul, it's all but over. Full court press is on. Thompson trapped, passed it out of bounds. So you know what? Mavericks are going to get another possession. 20.6 seconds left. And a foul with 14.1 seconds left. Oh boy.
Personal foul is on number 21, Brittany Bush. Her fifth. She has fouled out.
Jasmine Thompson went down at the end of that play, and she's being helped back to the training room. It is unlikely that we'll have an update before we go off the air today. I can only hope that she's okay. In the meantime, Brittany Bush fouled out. She's a right is in. So it's Price, Wright, Walker, Goff, and Nolan. First free throw, no good for Williams. Second one is good. So 73-61. And a quick foul.
Personal foul is on number 22, Layla Suleiman, her fourth. Mavericks are over the net. At the line for the Bronx, number 3, Tanisha Walker, shooting 2.
Tanisha Walker shooting 2, she hits the first. Hits the second. 75-63. Ball goes out of bounds with 1.1 seconds left. Price inbounds into a full court press. They tried to foul before the shot, before the clock expired. I don't know why. So Bronx wins 75-63. The Bronx at 6-4, tie for the best start in program history. How about that? Make sure you stay tuned on the postgame show. We're joined by Bronx head coach Larry Tidwell, at least we're expected to be. We'll give him a minute to come over. First, I think he's going to go over to Dolia Gonzalez. Let's see. Oh, now he's going to talk with Athletic Director Chris King. So, give us a chance to look at some of the final numbers. We will start with UT Arlington. 17 points for Suleiman on 5 of 8 shooting, 5 of 7 from behind the arc. 2 boards, 3 assists. 11 points for Pope. 7 rebounds, 2 steals. 10 points for Green, 4 of 5 shooting, 2 of 2 from behind the arc. Everybody else in single figures, 9 for Walker, 6 each for Williams and Wanguma, and 4 for Teo. UTA, 22 for 49 from the field, that's 45%, 7 of 15 from behind the arc, 47%, 12 of 16 from the line, 75%. As for the Bronx, Bronx led in scoring by Shantae Goff. Career high 25 points on 8 of 11, shooting 7 of 10 from behind the arc. A couple of free throws as well, 2 rebounds. Career high 22 points for Jasmine Thompson on 7 of 16 shooting. 3-pointer, 7 of 8 from the line. That's a career best. 5 rebounds. Career high tying 3 steals. 7 points for Tonisha Walker. 6 points, 5 rebounds for Brittany Bush. 5 points, 4 assists for Alexandria Hill. 5 points, 7 rebounds, 2 steals, Tandria Nolan. 3 points, Shazay Wright. 2 points, Sherelle Price. Bronx, 9 of 25 from the, or check that, 20 of 52 from the field. 9 of 25 wouldn't be very much for a game. 39%, 11 of 29 from behind the arc, that's 38%. 24 for 33 from the line, 73%, that's pretty good. Points in the paint. UTA 24, UTPA 12. Points off turnovers, though. UTPA 29, UTA 18. Second chance points, 8 for the Bronx, 6 for the Mavs. 2 fast break points each. UTA's bench 14 points, the Bronx 10. There was 1 lead change and 3 ties. We'll give you all these numbers. But the only ones that matter, 75 to 63, the Bronx defeat UT Arlington. And it was a game that, you know, Bronx were down 13 in the first half. Ended up coming back, scored to lead by 14. They turned around 27 points in this game, which is incredibly impressive. Bronx improved to 6-4. They tie for the best start in program history with a win on Saturday against Nebraska Omaha. The Bronx will have the best record in program, or best start in program history, at least, through right now 10 games, then 11 games. Coach Shidwell thanking some of the fans for coming. He is just a couple of feet to the right. That's why you keep seeing me looking over, just watching for him to come over. He'll be here any second, though. Mavericks fall to 0-10 this season. Don't let the record fool you. I mean, you saw it today. They're not a bad team. I mean, they've played a really tough schedule. And I wouldn't be surprised they win some games come Sun Belt Conference play. Bronx next opponent, that's the University of Nebraska Omaha. From what I'm told, a pretty similar team to UT Arlington. That's Saturday, 1 o'clock. And the Wichita State Winter Classic. And then, of course, Sunday, they take on host Wichita State. And then after a few days off, go to Oklahoma State to close out non-conference play. So a very difficult schedule coming up. And then they open WAC play against arguably the 3 best schools not named UTPA in the WAC in Grand Canyon, Seattle, and Idaho. So certainly a tough road ahead, but you know what? Bronx are 6-4. That's a winning record, and they'll take that through 10 games, I would think.
Yes, sir.
We're now joined by Bronx head coach Larry Tidwell. And, Coach, it was raining threes for a little while there, huh?
Yeah, it was. Shantae Goff was incredible, and our other ones have got to hit them. But that's what we worked for, and we did pretty good at the line, not a bad percentage. Still got out-rebounded. I've got to address that, and I will. But you talk about some kids that played hard and fought off a really good UTA team that in the first half was on fire. I mean, they were on fire. What do you do? I mean, they shot 67% from the three in the first half, and we're getting a hand up. So it is what it is. We'll just keep working.
And you know, you turned around 27 points today. You were down by 13, ended up up by as many as 14.
Yeah, I don't like that. I like to be ahead, stay ahead. So we'll see.
All right, Coach, well, hopefully all you're right. Ahead and stay ahead against Nebraska Omaha.
Oh, we got us another win. That's so important. Thank you.
Thank you. All right. Bronx head coach Larry Tidwell. Bronx wins 75-63 over UT Arlington. And that'll do it for us from the UTPA Fieldhouse. I'd like to thank everybody out there for tuning in. This has been a presentation of Bronx Basketball. For more information, you can log on to utpabronx.com. If you ever want to reach us, send an email. Contact information's up on the website under Inside Athletics. Click on Staff Directory. But for now, for Jim Bob Sides in the control room and the entire camera crew, and of course, for Dutch Cowgill, may you rest in peace. This is Jonah Goldberg saying goodnight in the UTPA Fieldhouse. Bronx win, 75-63.